Magandang araw mga kapamilya. Today is Saturday, Feast of St. Gregory the Great. Our Mass Presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. Blessed Gregory, raised upon the throne of Peter, sought always the beauty of the Lord and lived in celebration of that love.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. O God, who care for your people with gentleness and rule them in love, through the intercession of Pope St. Gregory, endow, we pray, with the spirit of wisdom, those to whom you have given authority to govern, that the flourishing of your holy flock may become the eternal joy of the shepherds. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, learn from myself and Apollos not to go beyond what is written, so that none of you will be inflated with pride in favor of one person over against another. Who confers distinction upon you? What do you possess that you have not received? But if you have received it, why are you boasting as if you did not receive it? You are already satisfied. You have already grown rich. You have become kings without us. Indeed, I wish that you had become kings so that we also might become kings with you. For as I see it, God has exhibited us, apostles, as the last of all, like people sentenced to death, since we have become a spectacle to the world, to angels and men alike. We are fools on Christ's account, but you are wise in Christ. We are weak, but you are strong. You are held in honor, but we in disrepute. To this very hour, we go hungry and thirsty. We are poorly clad and roughly treated. We wander about homeless and we toil, working with our own hands. When ridiculed, we bless. When persecuted, we endure. When slandered, we respond gently. We have become like the world's rubbish, the scum of all, to this very moment. I am writing you this not to shame you, but to admonish you as my beloved children. Even if you should have countless guides to Christ, yet you do not have many fathers, for I became your father in Christ Jesus through the gospel. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is near to all who call upon him.
The Lord is near to all who call upon him.
The Lord is just in all his ways and holy in all his works. The Lord is near to all who call upon him, to all who call upon him in truth.
The Lord is near to all who call upon him.
He fulfills the desire of those who fear him. He hears their cry and saves them. The Lord keeps all who love him, but all the wicked he will destroy.
The Lord is near to all who call upon him.
May my mouth speak the praise of Lord, and may all flesh bless his holy name forever and ever.
The Lord is near to all who call upon him.
Alleluia, alleluia. I am the way and the truth and the life, says the Lord. No one comes to the Father except through me. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
While Jesus was going through a field of grain on a Sabbath, his disciples were picking the heads of grain, rubbing them in their hands, and eating them. Some Pharisees said, "Why are you doing what is unlawful on the Sabbath?" Jesus said to them in reply, "Have you not read what David did when he and those who were with him were hungry? How they went into the house of God, took the bread of offering, which only priests could lawfully eat, ate it and shared it with his companions?" Then he said to them, "The Son of Man is Lord of the Sabbath." My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today, as I said yesterday, is a continuation, partly a continuation of the Gospel. Remember yesterday we were talking about the newness of the message of Christ and the newness which actually brings us back to the original or the core intent, no, the essence of religion or God's relationship or man's relationship with God. No? So here you have that again, no, when the Lord puts mercy, no, mercy and compassion above legalities and the letter of the law, so to speak. No? So you have that first point. No? Again, that newness by bringing it back to the original intent of love and mercy. No? That's the first point that we will reflect on. No? And then the second point that I just want to invite you to reflect on is that, you know, time and again, the Lord would always refer to, you might say, the heroes of the Old Testament. Here you have David and several, and then you have Moses. Of course, time and again, he would refer to the prophets, no? And even Abraham, no? Isaac. And then I think that is very important for us to reflect on also, no? Who are the role models, if you wish, no? Of our journey. Who are worthy of our emulation? That second point to reflect on. And then the third and final point is just going back to that simple message of the Lord. No, I demand mercy, not sacrifice, which is part of what the Lord is saying when he said that he is the Lord of the Sabbath. No, so itong tatlong punto ito na ating pagninilayan batay sa Ebanghelyo ngayong araw, no, yung binabanggit nga natin kahapon, yung pagbabago ng yung bagong mensahe ng Panginoon, at makikita natin dito na yung tinatawag na newness, no, o yung pagkasariwa ng mensahe niya ay dahil nga binabalik niya, no, sa original na kahulugan ng ating relihiyon, ng ating ugnayan sa Diyos, no, pagmamahal at pagkalinga at awa, no, mercy. At yung pangalawang punto ay binibigyan niya tayo ng mga ehemplo dito sa Ebanghelyo ngayon, si David yung kanyang pinakita, pero sa ibang Ebanghelyo, yung pag-uusapan niya ang mga propeta, si Moses, si Abraham, etc., na ito yung mga karapat-dapat nating sundan, ano, at gawing ehemplo ng ating buhay. At yung huling punto nga ng pagninila, yung sinasabi ng Panginoon, ang kailangan ko ay pagkalinga at awa at hindi yung sakripisyo na sinusunod lamang ang ritual, ano. So yung pangatlong punto. So let's take a look at that first point, no, which is again very 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 important in the ministry of Christ, and eventually this is what will partly get him into trouble. Remember, one of the main issues of the Lord's conflict with the religious authorities is the whole law of the Sabbath, no. But here the Lord very clearly says, no, that we must go back to the original meaning of our faith, our religion, no, and the original meaning of the law. Again, as we mentioned yesterday, the religious authorities through the centuries distorted the meaning of the law, whereas the law was supposed to define and make clearer our relationship with God and give us, in a sense, guidelines on how to live out that relationship in our day-to-day lives. It became a burden. So here the Lord is in a sense liberating us, no? That is the newness of His message. It is a liberating message. Siguro yung unang punto na mahalaga na dapat natin mapalalim ang ating pag-unawa at ang ating appreciation na ang mensahe ng Panginoon ay nagbabalik sa atin kung saan nagsimula lahat. No? Yung ating pagmamahal sa Diyos, ang pagmamahal ng Diyos sa atin. At ito nga yung sinasabi natin na ang batas noon ay ang gabay para masabuhay natin sa araw-araw itong covenant natin sa Diyos, no, hindi para tayo ay bigyan ng pabigat, kundi para mas malaya at malinaw tayong makasunod sa ating relasyon sa Diyos. At yun ang sinasabi ng Panginoon. Ito yung pagkasiriwa ng kanyang mensahe. Yung pagpapalaya sa atin, spiritual freedom. No? At yung the second point, no, is that, again, citing examples, I think, it's very, very important. No? You know, as an educator, that was one of our major concerns in schools, no? That our young people had role models. And our young people had role models on which or on whom they could pattern their lives, no? As examples. Because a lot of the learning of young people is by example, no? They imitate whatever they see or whatever they are exposed to, no? So I think the Lord inciting all of these, you might say, spiritual giants of the Old Testament is very good, in a sense, teaching technique, very good pedagogy when he cites the people who are respected by all. No? And I think we need that now. We need to uphold more and more people who are worthy of emulation. I think that's a very important, again, soul searching that we need to make. No? Who should be uphold, no, as role models worthy to emulate in our lives and in the lives of our family, our communities, especially the youth. No? Siguro yung pangalawang punto, na para sa akin, napakahalagang punto at bahagi yan ng ating pananampalataya na ang Diyos nagbibigay. Yan din ang masasabi natin, role ng mga banal, no, na nagiging ehemplo sila na pwedeng masunod ng mga ng lahat tayo, no, lalong-lalo na ng kabataan. Mahalaga bilang isang educator, bilang isang guro, mahalaga sa kabataan na merong role models. Meron silang isang ehemplo kung saan nila maisusunod ang kanilang buhay, no? Yung pangalawang punto na yon na ating pagnilayan. And then the third and final point is that beautiful message of the Lord. It is mercy that I demand, not sacrifice. Of course, that is not in the gospel for today, but that is part of the essential message of the gospel, that it is the needs of the people, the needs that we can see out of love, mercy, and compassion, more than the ritual sacrifice. Because in a sense, sometimes the rituals, the ceremonies, the sacrifices became a tool against the people. But here, very clearly, in the same way that Pope Francis said, remember, at the beginning of his papacy, we must place the mercy of God above all things. No? Siguro yung huling punto na yun, yun ang masasabi nating pinakamahalagang elemento ng ating pananampalataya. Ang pagmamahal at ang pagkalinga at ang habag at awa ng Diyos sa atin. Let us continue our Mass and let us ask the Lord to, again, help us develop a deeper understanding and appreciation of these elements of our faith. Let us pray to God our Father, who has called us all His sons and daughters to become free in His Son, Jesus Christ. To each prayer, our response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
That Christians may regard the commandments of God as doors to freedom from sin and evil, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who work in law enforcement and government may consistently place the welfare of the people above legalistic concerns, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That in worshiping the God whom we cannot see, we may not forget our needy brothers whom we see, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us remember all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. For all this we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And together now, let us offer our prayer for our nation. Panginoon ng kasaysayan, sa aming paghahanda para sa 125th anibersaryo ng pagsilang ng aming bansa, sabayan mo po kami sa aming proyekto na magtatag ng 1,000 may tunay na kalayaan para sa lahat. Kalayaang nakaugat sa pagkalinga, hustisya at katotohanan, kalayaan mula sa kahirapan, na nag-aalis mula sa nakararami ng pagkakataong mapabuti ang kanilang buhay, kalayaan mula sa gutom, kawalan ng tirahan, at kakulangan ng dekalidad ng mga simpleng serbisyo sa pangangalaga ng kalusugan at sa edukasyon, kalayaan mula sa panlilinlang, kasinungalingan at manipulasyon, kalayaan upang maging mga aktibo at positibong tagapagbuo ng aming bansa. Bigyan mo kami ng katatagan ng loob at inspirasyon na walang humpay na itaguyod ang isang bansang tunay na malaya para sa lahat ng mga Pilipino. Amen. By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. To your goodness we have this bread and this wine to offer. Fruit of the earth, fruit of the vine, and work of human hands, they will become for us our spiritual food, our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Grant our supplication, we pray, O Lord, that this sacrifice we present in celebration of Saint Gregory may be for our good, since through its offering you have loosed the offenses of all the world through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For us on the festival of Saint Gregory, you bid your church rejoice, so do you strengthen her by the example of his holy life, teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, again he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Remember, Father Most Holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. have mercy on us all, we pray. That with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with Saint Pope Gregory, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin and protect us from all anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And together let us offer, let us spend a few moments of silence. And together let us now offer our prayer for an end to the pandemic and the rebuilding of our nation.
Merciful and compassionate Father, we humbly come to you to find forgiveness and life. We come to ask for your grace and guidance as we emerge from this pandemic. Bless all those who help see us through the challenges the pandemic brought, those who tirelessly work to render genuine service, especially to those who suffered the most. Guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission and to end this pandemic. Heal all who are afflicted. Grant eternal rest to those who died and consolation to their loved ones. As we move forward, grant us the grace to see clearly, choose well, and act right in order to build a nation closer to your kingdom of justice, truth, equality, faith, hope, compassion, and love. Grant all these through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not deny our petition, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
Saint Roch.
Pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu.
Have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy.
Have mercy on us. And let us pray. Through Christ the Teacher, O Lord, instruct those you feed with Christ the living bread, that on the feast day of Saint Gregory they may learn your truth and express it in works of charity, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us now offer our prayer for peace and joy for our world. Father in heaven, to you we offer this prayer in the words of our Holy Father, Pope Francis. We have so much to do and we must do it together. In the darkness of the conflicts we are living through, each of us can become a bright candle to remind us that light will overcome darkness and never the other way around. To us Christians, the future has a name and its name is hope. It is the virtue of the heart that does not lock itself up, does not dwell on the past, and not only survives the present, but is able to see tomorrow. Bless our world, Father, with the peace and joy that the cross and resurrection of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, won for us. For all those affected by calamities natural and man-made, for all those who suffer from the structural injustices of our time, amen. Our Lady, Mother of God and Mother of the Church,
pray for us.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Again, marami pong salamat for joining us. And again, have a good weekend ahead. And please join us for Proyecto Pilipino and Journeys of Hope this weekend. Thank you.
Bagyo, lindol, volcanic eruption, pagbaha, at iba pang mga delubyo at kalamidad. Ilan lamang ito sa mga hirap na kinakaharap natin dala ng climate emergency at planetary crisis. O marahil, dala ng ating kapabayaan. Dahil pinayagan natin ang walang puknat na pagmimina, illegal logging at quarrying, coal at fossil fuel operations. Sinira natin ang karagatan dahil sa basura at illegal fishing. Maging ang ating coral reef ay namamatay na rin. Subalit may pag-asa pa kung tayo ay magtutulungan. Ipagtanggol natin ang karapatan ng kalikasan. Ipaglaban natin ang ating nag-iisang tahanan. Samahan ninyo kami sa Caritas Philippines sa ating pag-aalay sa kalikasan.